Okay. Somebody say yes.
Yes, teacher.
Sure.
Okay. And Friday, we have laboratory class, but I'm going to make theory class. So we no need to go to laboratory. I'm going to make theory class. And today, October 26th, and Friday, it's going to be October 30th, right? Yes. I'm going to make review information for the midterm exam. Because next week, Lunes, we don't have classes. Just wait. Do you remember which day I told you we have exam?
I think it was November 4th.
Yes, you're right. It was, I told you, November 4th. Just let me, I'm open now calendar. Just November 4th. It's Wednesday. It's 1 hour class, right? Yes. Wednesday we had 1 hour class.
Yes,
so
it's just 1 hour.
Yeah, 1 hour we cannot complete exam. So what we do? See, next Wednesday, November 4, we still going to make laboratoria class. Laboratoria. But Friday, November 6th, we are going to have exam theory class. Is everyone okay?
Yes, sure.
So, please, yes, people, sorry about this little bit changes, but see, Wednesday we cannot make final exam because it's 1 hour class. In one hour, maybe it's not enough for you. That's why Wednesdays, again, we are going to make, I mean, not this, next week. Wednesday, again, we are going to make laboratoria. And class Friday, when supposed to be laboratoria, we are going to make theoria class. And in this theoria class, November 6th, we are going to make final exam. See?
Teacher.
Yes. Luis, you asking me something? Oh, I cannot hear.
I'm just agree with the new dates for the exam.
Yeah, how do you like November 6th is good, Luis?
Yeah, it's correct, teacher.
Yeah, it's okay, it's good. Uh-huh. Leslie, are you here?
Yes, teacher.
Are you crying?
No, teacher.
Okay. Okay, so Leslie, November 6th, we have exam. Okay? It's next week, Friday.
Yes, teacher, it's okay.
Yeah, okay. Good. So everyone, please remember, and people who is not in class, and if you have contact, if you can contact to them, please explain them that it's we are going to have exam in November 6. Okay, so but today we have review class, Mercules this week, we have laboratory class, Friday this week, we are going to have again review class, like information to prepare you for the final exam. Excuse me. Okay, today we are going to have review class. Just let me prepare my. Okay. So, review, it's going to be like two parts. First part that it's today, I'm going to cover everything from fluid mechanics and aerodynamica, basic aerodynamica that we necessity to remember to understand all processes going on in aerodynamica. Today just mostly like about basic fluid mechanics and basic aerodynamics. Next class, next review class this Friday, this week Friday, I'm going to cover all information that is related to the aerodynamica itself, like starting from airfoil and everything important that is going to be in final exam. In final exam is going to be no calculations, because all calculations that you made so far, remember, like you made some calculation at home, but you made some calculation in class, last few classes, remember?
Yes, teacher.
So this resultados is going, I'm going to include to final exam as a part like calculation when you calculated some like parameters like coefficient of the lift and something else. Okay. But today about basic of fluid mechanics and basic of from physica in general. Okay, it's important because of using this basic laws or lays, we can solve almost any problem in aerodynamica and fluid mechanics, and also in hydrodynamica actually. But hydrodynamica, I'm not going to touch this subject because it's our class just aerodynamica. But what is main difference between aerodynamica and hydrodynamica? That it's air is gas, it's compressible, liquid, hydrodynamica, liquid. It's a liquid fluidus, it's a non-compressible material, and it makes like a main difference between aerodynamica and hydrodynamica. But now about like five basic laws that used to solve, to understand or to solve almost any problem in fluid mechanics and in aerodynamica. And this is five is conservation of mass, Newton's laws of motion, conservation of momentum, first law thermodynamica and second law thermodynamica. Conservation of mass, it states that it's mass of any mass in any isolated system remain constant over the time. And if this mass close to all external material and energy, because if we apply some energy, we can increase mass or decrease mass. So here, in isolated system, amount of mass remains constant. Why it's important for the fluid mechanics and aerodynamics? Because of in fluid mechanics, we have one of the important things that it's a continuity equation, continuity principle, that states that it's amount of the fluids entering to the system equal amount of fluids on the exit of this system. And this one is helps us to understand Birnoulli's principle, which states conservation of the energy, that its total amount of energy remains constant, and it's based on the principle of the total amount of the mass in isolated system remains constant. So, the equation of mass. Newton's law of motion. All Newton's law of motions, it's it's just about forces and masses of the bodies, interacting forces and masses of the bodies in different condition. And we have Newton's first, second, and third law. And first, Newton's first law states that it's any object remains that it stay at rest and remains stay at rest, and any object in motion will stay in this motion with constant velocity if all forces acting on this object is equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So any object, if it stays in some condition, in static condition at the rest, it will stay at the rest if we don't change some magnitude of some forces in some direction. The same in any object in motion, if it's moving with some constant velocity, it means that it's all forces acting on this object, it's equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. And if we change even one force, magnitude of one force, we are going to change situation, for example, increasing or decreasing velocity. This is important, for example, like Newton's first law. Remember when you made some calculations, for example, coefficient of the lift, to consider magnitude of the lift, you just used physical pass of the avion, correct? Because acting four forces on avion, pass, lift, thrust, and arrastre. And here in motion of the avion with constant altura and constant velocity, magnitude of peso equal magnitude of the lift, or opposite way, magnitude of the lift, the avion supposed to create lift equal absolutely in same magnitude as the peso, but in opposite direction. This is Newton's first law. Newton's second law, it's about force. Force, it's very simple, equal mass times acceleration. So remember, mass times acceleration, it's force. Peso, it's also force. Peso, it's equal mass times acceleration due to gravity. Newton's third law, it's action-reaction principle. Action-reaction principle that states that for every action, there is equal and opposite direction of the reaction. And this principle using, for example, in lift force, for example, if wind blows to some surface of the plate, and it's creating some forces, that it's action equal reaction force. Magnitude is equal, but not opposite, it's just like different directions. Also, like Newton's third law, it's when we speak about like rocket engine, for example. Rocket engine creating thrust and creating movement of the rocket based on the principle action reaction, Newton's third law. Questions so far?
No, did you?
No, because this is very simple from our school program, even. Next, conservation of momentum. This lay is states that it's total amount of the momentum, like total momentum of the sistema, remains constant. And it's absolutely correct. It's absolutely true. Like a total amount of momentum remains constant. Very first, momentum, it's a massa times velocidad. Force is massa times acceleration. Momentum is massa times velocidad. And remember, just law of conservation of momentum, it states that it's a total amount of momentum of the system remains constant. Or the same thing, we can say total momentum of the isolated systema of interacting bodies remains constant. Interacting bodies, for example, like in one container or in one something, we have three or four few like steel balls, and all of them moving, and all of them like touching each other, changing direction, changing velocidad. But total amount of this momentum of this like total box or total container, before this interacting body starts movement and after they start movement, like in any time interval, like time uno, time dos, time tres, time cuatro, total amount of momentum in all these time periods remains constant. And very simple example here, like if we see a helicopter, who's pilot today, like Leslie, are you here? Leslie, sleeping?
No, teacher.
No, okay, good, senorita. So, Leslie, you are pilot, boy, okay?
You are okay, teacher.
In this helicopter, okay? Now, before you start motor of this helicopter, before you start motor, all these blades, main rotor blades, tail rotor blades, it's not moving. In this condition, according to the law of conservation of momentum, total amount of momentum here equal zero, correct? Because no movement at all, because no velocidad, nothing. Correct? Say yes, Leslie.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Next, now you are like a pilot, Senorita Preciosa, you turn on motor and we starting, like helicopter starts to rotate main rotor blades. And this main rotor blades rotation, it's this rojo lineas, counterclockwise. It's rotating this way, counterclockwise, and right away, like, and you're rotating very slow and now increasing RPM. And what happened? Because of conservation of momentum, remember, momentum of this system was total amount of momentum, it was zero, right? Now we are creating rotation of the blade, and now momentum, it's not zero, because some mass times some velocity, it's creating momentum rotating this way. But according to the conservation of momentum, it's mass to be zero. To make it zero, fuselage with tail boom, all this another main parts of the helicopter will start to rotate this verde, shows direction of the rotation, opposite way to the rotation to the blades. So blades are rotating counterclockwise, fuselage rotating clockwise. Porque, very simple, porque conservation of momentum. When blades rotating counterclockwise, fuselage rotating clockwise, total amount of momentum remains constant, remains zero, as it was at the very beginning. That's why to keep fuselage straight, not to rotate, helicopter necessita tail rotor here. This small one, it's tail rotor, and blades of the tail rotor has also airfoil form, and it's also creating difference in pressure, and it's creating fluid flow and thrust. And this direction of this thrust, Amarillo, it's opposite to the direction of this verde torque. So where the torque or like conservation of momentum try to rotate blades this way, but tail rotor creating thrust opposite way, and magnitude of Amarillo equal magnitude of verde. So this is, for example, plus, this is minus. And this plus and minus equal magnitude, it making helicopter's fuselage stays straight. It's not rotating. But still, total amount of momentum here now it's... Understand?
Yes, teacher.
So this is conservation of momentum. Just remember, conservation of momentum, it's from physics, and it's working always. Doesn't matter if you want or if we don't want it working always. For example, when we're driving car straight, like forward, and it has some momentum, mass times velocity. Now, when we're making left turn, some force pushing our body to the right side. Porque car moving left, but momentum, inertia pushing us to the right. Porque to keep total amount of momentum equal zero. This is about conservation of momentum. Next, first law thermodynamic and second law thermodynamic. These two laws of the thermodynamic for the application in fluid mechanics and aerodynamics, it's no necessita formula, no necessita calculation. It's just physical meaning of this laws, first law and second law, because we have to understand that it's any system, if it has mass, it has like some internal potential energy. And this energy can be transformed to change from one form to another form but no possible to be destroyed or to be created. In other words, nobody is able to create new energy. It's not possible. And nobody is able to destroy existing energy. It's not possible. What does it mean? It means that it's, if we cannot create and if we cannot destroy, it means that it's total amount of energy, it just exists. And what we do so far to make even like electricity or any other type of the useful form of the energy, we are transforming this energy from one type to useful type. For example, to produce electricity, we can use few way of the transformation of the energy. For example, carbon or gas natural or petroleum, we can use as a fuel to create electricity by the transforming this internal energy of these materials to the heat, because using combustion process, during this process, this material releases a huge amount of the heat, color. This color boiling agua forming vapor creating huge pressure. This pressure rotating turbina rotating ehe. On ehe, we have bobinas, that it's a rotor, it's rotating with bobina. And around this bobinas, a rotor, we have another set of the bobinas, that it's stator, rotor bobinas, rotating inside stator bobinas, and it's creating electromagnetic field. And this electromagnetic field induced movement of the electrons in metal, in copper or in aluminum, for example. And it's we creating electricity. And we are using this electricity, for example, to turn on refrigerator. And in this refrigerator, we have cerveza. And we can drink this cerveza and watch TV and enjoy life. Correct?
Yes, teacher.
Oh, good. So we can only transform energy, but we cannot destroy energy and we cannot create energy. It's first one, second one, amount of energy just existing. So, and even around us on Tierra existing huge amount of the energy, we are using some forms of this energy and we're transforming this energy to something useful. For example, for the gasoline to run our cars. But still existing a lot of amount of energy around us, and we know that it's existing this energy, but we don't know yet technically how to use this energy, how to make it like transform to technical applications this energy. Example, magnetic field of the Tierra. Magnetic field of the Tierra, our planet, has huge amount of like potential energy. We don't know how to use it to transform to useful forma, for example, to move car. Another one, gravitation. Gravitation field, gravitation, it has some potential like energy and gravity. And so far, we don't know technically how to use energy of the gravity instead like using carbon or gas natural. And some another type of energies also existing around us, we don't know. It looks like right here, we can touch it, but still we cannot. we know that it's existing, but we don't know like how to transform this inertia to useful form. And this one, it's all about first law of thermodynamics. Second law of thermodynamics, it's states that it's in any system, always, always going on some changes. And this is changes going on because of difference in temperature. For example, in temperature, in pressure, in chemical potential, in densidad, in color, in some another condition. It's a lot of parameters properties. Like difference in properties over the time in is isolated system will come to the equilibrium to your equilibrium. It means that it's going on changes to get some balance condition. After this parameters or system gets this balance condition, it's still going on. It's never stopped these changes. These changes will continue to the condition of the system with higher P. Always system changes, and these changes goes on from the point of entropy to the point of the higher entropy. From the point of entropy where is weak, to the point where entropy is strong. And this is always going on changes. That's why in any system, physical system, it's going on changes. And why we say in isolated system? Because in system that we're making some analysis, because isolated system also we can consider all our universe. In all our universe scale, it's always going on like processes according to the second law of thermodynamics. And this is changes that is going on like according to the second law of thermodynamics. We can explain in few. One of them, for example, no process is possible where only result is the transfer of the heat from body of lower temperature to body of the higher temperature. No process is possible. The temperature travel from the higher, from the lower to the higher. It means that it's, if we, in the room, at room temperature, if we take piece of ice from the refrigerator and put on the surface of the table, only possible one way to going on changes. What happened? Ice over the time is going to melt, and from the solid it's transfers to the liquid, from the liquid to vapor. But room temperature is going to be lower. Por qué? Porque energía always moves, or temperature always moves, or heat always moves from the high point temperature to lower point of the temperature, not opposite way. No possible that it's ice getting colder and room temperature it's getting higher. No, only opposite way, room temperature getting lower because some energy heat from the room temperature goes toward ice, and ice increasing temperature now and it's melting. Only one way it's possible to move heat or to transfer heat or transfer energy. Another way to explain second law thermodynamics is that it's heat flows from the hot body to the cool one. First, second one. Nobody can convert heat completely in useful work. No possible completely convert like heat to 100% of the heat to 100% of the work, no possible. And every isolated system becomes disordered in the time. It's just about time. Time, how long it takes, 5 minutes, 5 years, 5 months, 5 years, 5,000 years, doesn't matter. It's just about like time, but any isolated system becomes disordered. Remember here, it's going to get to the equilibrium, any difference, get to the equilibrium, and after equilibrium, any isolated system becomes disordered. Because disordered condition has higher entropy than balanced condition. And this is changes going on non-stop all the time. And second law thermodynamics, very first it works in physics as a science, as a like a subject, like real life, as in any engineering experience. Just remember about second law thermodynamics. How to remember? For example, fluid always moves from the point of higher pressure to the point of the lower pressure, never opposite way, never. Temperature travels always from the higher temperature toward lower temperature, never opposite way. For example, another things that it's like any system, if you have some difference in some parameters, in some properties of the system, it's just about time, but it's by the time it's must to come to some balance point, and after this balance point, it must to come to some disordered point. In other words, second law of thermodynamics says that it's we don't have anything on this theory and in our universe that it's existing forever. Nothing existing forever except Mexico. Say yes.
Of course, sure.
Yes. And
yes, of course.
Yes, absolutely, I agree. Because see, any imperia, even in historia, any imperia in Tierra, his historia, no one imperia exists forever. Like ancient imperias, like if you see, they were sometimes in time, like in our past, they exist, but they disappear after. Like Egyptian empire, like empire, Osman Empire, Soviet Union, if you consider as an empire, it was like sometimes like it was existing, now it doesn't exist. It's just not because of like fighting or something, it's just like normal second law of thermodynamics. Nothing exists forever. United States in this form, they cannot exist forever. It's not possible. It's just about time, but how long it takes, like 2 years, 20 years, 2,000 years, but anyway, sometimes in future, it's going to be punto in historia where is no anymore United States existing in this form. Only one exception, Mexico, right? Even like imperia, like Mayan imperia in like in Mexico historia, it's North America. It was like North and South America, correct? Mayan imperia, because it's in the central of America, right? It was like part of North, part of South America, Mayan imperia. Am I right or no? People doesn't know historia. Okay. Leslie, are you still here?
Yes, sure.
Leslie, do you know anything about historia? Like Mayan imperia, it was like was part in the Mexico and in south part of the America, right?
Yes, teacher.
Some in other countries, correct?
Can you repeat the question, please?
Question was, you know, like Mayo Imperia, right?
Yes.
And where it was location, like it was huge imperia, and it was in Peru. It was Mayan, yes. In Mexico, it was Maya. It's yes, correct. It was like huge territory, and now we don't have this imperia because of few reasons we can found like in Historia, but the main reason it's main reason because the second law of thermodynamics, according to the second law of thermodynamics, nothing existing forever. It's always changes, like even our Tierra, it's like it has some limit of in its life, because no possible our Tierra will exist forever. No, it's just because of second law of thermodynamics. And this second law of thermodynamics, it's proved. And that's why even like Amor, any Amor is just about time, how long, like dos dias, tres dias, maybe semanas, maybe 3 years, maybe 10 years, but any Amor will finish. Leslie, don't cry.
I'm not crying, teacher.
It's reality, right? We have to accept. Okay. So this is first law thermodynamic and second law thermodynamic. In application of fluid mechanics and aerodynamics, porque we have to remember about this law of thermodynamics because of always going on changes and always about energy. We cannot create energy, we cannot destroy energy. Amount energy is just existing. It's it helps us to understand Bernoulli's principle, where it states that its total amount of energy in any fluid fluha remains constant. But we have only those variables, pressure and velocidad. So if we increase in velocidad, something must to happen to pressure. Pressure drops down. If we decrease in velocidad, pressure goes up. Bernoulli's principle, and it's based on the first and second law of thermodynamics. Now, fluidos, it's liquidos and gases. Fluidos has a lot of properties that it's absolutely the same like properties of the solids. For example, densidad. Like densidad for the solid and the, for the fluidus, it's massa per unit volume, it's the same, densidad. How to change densidad, it's also something similar in the solid and in the fluidus. Like densidad with increasing, decreasing pressure, or increasing or decreasing volume, it's densidad is changes, but how it changes, it's similar in solids and in fluidus. Next, for example, specific gravity, peso specifica, some of these parameters absolutely the same for the solids and for the fluids. But only fluids has property, unique property that doesn't have solid. It's viscosidad. And viscosidad, it's property of fluid that it's making like a lot of influences, a lot of it's induced some like forces, aerodynamic forces that appears just in aerodynamica and in hydrodynamica, not in solid dynamica. This is because of viscosity, we have like skin friction, we have non-slip condition, and we have arrastra forces that it's specific only for the aerodynamica. And here, speaking about like fluids, we have in general gases and liquidos. main difference between gases and liquidos that it's gases, they're compressible, liquidos non-compressible. It's main differences. And as soon as compressible, not compressible, even like to create some movement of the object in the air and in the liquid, its dynamica is different. Porque? Because of different viscosidad, and it's creating different resistance force, because viscosidad, it's internal property of the fluidos, internal property of the gases or liquidos, that it's creating resistance to flow or creating resistance to deformation. In other words, we can say this it's rate of the fluidity, kind of like a fluidity, it's kind of like not parameters, property of the fluidos. How is liquid is this fluid? And this is viscosidad. And it's once again, viscosidad, it's internal property of the fluidos to create resistance to deformation or to create resistance to flow. And this viscosidad, one of the main reasons, it's to creating arrastra force, skin friction force, drag force. And that's why this drag force in air, it's existing in air and in existing in hydro, in aqua, but because of different magnitude, so that's why some like animals, some birds in the air or fish in the hydro, in the oceano, in aqua, different forma, and they have different principle to create motion. But what is common for both of them? Both of them, as soon as they are creating movement forward, thrust forward, it's creating movement of the air around this object in opposite way. In our also movement of this in opposite way, and also it's creating arrastra force that it's in magnitude is equal to the thrust force, but direction is opposite direction to the thrust for the bird and for the fish also. And this is about viscosidad. Speaking about viscosidad, viscosidad is, once again, it's an internal property of the fluid to create to resistance to deformation. And better to understand viscosidad, let's see like two plates. One plate is here. And this is statica plate. An upper plate. So this is statica, it's just like nails. It stays here. An upper plate, if we apply some force F, we are creating movement in this direction. And this direction, this movement has some velocity equal, for example, this velocity maximum is here, minimum is here. Porque? Porque here, zero velocity condition, it happened because viscosidad. If this fluidos, this roja, or rosa, right? Rosa fluidos, it's moving between these two places or deforming because we drag this one, it's moving upper plate, this plate is statica. So this fluidos or liquid between these two plates is deforming. And deforming in way that it's like velocity of this fluidos related to this plate right here, just on the surface, equal zero. And on the top part, this velocity equal V, some number. And as soon as we're creating this movement, to understand this movement, we can use even this angle better, because at the beginning, before we apply this force, it was like straight vertical linear. And after we apply force, this linear that it's n like n, punto n, now punto n here, it's moving to the punto n here, n dash. Moving here, and this distance, it's dA, it's just distance that it's move under application, that is this punto move under application of force F. As the rate of this movement, we can describe by this angle beta, like difference in beta, it gives us picture of the movement, of the magnitude of this movement of the top plate. And something similar to this angle is distribution of the velocity vector. So minimum velocity or zero velocity just on the contact zone here, and maximum velocity here on the maximum distance from on this plate. And this distribution of velocity vector similar to this angle. And to describe this velocity profile, we can use this formula, very simple formula, and rate of the deformation of alpha in this vertical scale. And for can vertical scale, this distance L, and in 2D space, Y and X. So this is shear deformation or shear stress tau. We can describe as a changes in velocity related to the changes in vertical scale. So rate of shear stress, we can describe by this geometry and this formula. And this is very simple and understandable from physica and the simple mathematica. But see, let's say we have stress situation, una situation here between these two plates. We have awa, it's first situation. Second situation, between these two plates, we have crema. And third situation, between these two plates, we have now mia. And in all the stress situation, we apply the same force. Force equal like magnitude F. But after some times, we start the same time this movement in each of the stress situation, and we stop this movement after some period of time. And we can see alpha moves from N to N dash, like dA. Crema is going to move from here somewhere to here, and meal is going to move from here somewhere to here. See, everything the same, force applying the same, only like this distance is the same, only different material here. And we are going to have different of this rate, du by dy. Porque one important parameter here that we have considered, it's viscosidad. And this viscosidad, mu. Mu, it's dynamic viscosity or absolute viscosity of the fluids. And these properties, it's just properties of the fluids. Fluids, gases and liquids, because solids doesn't have this property. Questions so far?
No, teacher.
Teacher, is okay.
Okay, good. And here, for example, rate of the deformation on the horizontal linear, rate of the deformation on the horizontal linear, on the vertical linear, we have shear stress. Here, shear stress. Let's say if you take alpha. Now, zero stress, zero deformation. Now we apply some stress increase, like stress, right away we are increasing some like deformation. Mass stress, mass deformation. Mass stress, mass deformation. What does it mean? as soon as we apply some forces and we are creating some shear stress, right away we are creating shear deformation. And this rate of deformation is just increasing with shear stress right away. And this type of the fluids like agua, air, oil, leche, tea, coffee, a lot of things. And these things, all this type of the fluids, we call it Newtonian fluids. Another type of the fluids, for example, like zero shear stress, zero deformation, after we are increasing shear stress, see, for example, here, increasing shear stress, but just Chiquita shear rate of deformation. Increasing shear stress, like increasing rate of deformation, but not the same magnitude. See, shear stress like this distance, deformation just Chiquita. Mass, and somewhere right here, we are increasing shear stress and we are creating shear deformation here, mass and minus equal like for the hour. What does it mean? It means that some liquids, some fluids, we apply shear stress, we are creating shear deformation, but Chiquita. Increasing magnitude of shear stress, we are increasing deformation, but again, Chiquita. Increasing shear stress, increasing shear deformation, but not too much. And after some punto, we are increasing shear stress, now this liquid starts to act as a Newtonian fluid, like agua. And it's example for example, like toothpaste in tooth tube. We are applying some pressure, squeezing this tube. We can see this is toothpaste moving not right away. We have to apply more force, more squeeze, and after appears this toothpaste and it starts to move from the tube. Ketchup in the bottle. We shake this bottle, we squeeze bottle, ketchup not leaking. Squeeze more, ketchup not leaking. Squeeze more, and now ketchup leaks and it just like blow out from the bottle. And so this type of the fluids, we call it non-Newtonian fluids. An example of the non-Newtonian fluids is crema, miel, ketchup, pintura, toothpaste, and so on. This is example of the non-Newtonian fluids. And viscosidad, absolute viscosity or dynamic viscosity mu, it changes with changing temperature. And that's why we are using parameter as a cinematic viscosity. And cinematic viscosity, it's equal absolute viscosity divided by densidad. And porque densidad? Because densidad changes with increasing or decreasing temperature. Example, motor aceite, engine oil. It has some information, for example, TW30. What does it mean? 10, it's a parameter for the summertime, and W30, it's winter. It stands for the winter. Winter is just 30. It shows cinematic is viscosity parameters of this oil. So, for example, for the same caro, if like you using this caro in Juarez, it's one option, and same caro you are using in Toronto, in Canada. So, in Juarez, temperature much more higher, like ambient temperature, compared to Toronto. So to use engine oil for this, for your car, same car, in Juarez and in Toronto, you have to use different parameters of SAE, 5W30 or 10W30, because of different ambient temperature. Porque temperature important for the viscosidad? Because of viscosidad always changes with temperature. But viscosidad of liquidos and viscosidad of gases acting different under changing of temperature. Liquidos, any liquidos has viscosidad. And viscosidad of this liquidos decreases with increasing temperature. Example, miel. Just imagine you put miel in a refrigerator. After a couple hours, you take this miel from the refrigerator, and this miel now looks like plastilina. Very high density, very high viscosidad. It's here somewhere, viscosidad. Now you put this meal at room temperature and wait. By the time you can see, as a result of the second law of thermodynamics, it's a room temperature heat from going to heat up, increase temperature of the meal, and meal increasing temperature, it's increasing, changing its density, and this density changing viscosidad of the miel, and viscosidad drops down. So miel from plastilina, it's going to turn, melt down, it's like crema, and after that, maybe like agua. It depends on the temperature. So viscosidad of the liquidos decreases with increasing temperature. And viscosidad of the gases increasing with increasing temperature. In other words, viscosidad of the gases decreases if we decrease temperature. And remember, viscosidad, one of the most important parameters that it's induced like arrastre. Viscosidad, it's a reason porque appears arrastre, skin friction, non-slip condition, boundary layer, skin friction, it's induced arrastre, very strong arrastre. And this arrastre, because of viscosidad. And now imagine, if we decrease temperature, viscosidad is going to decrease. It means that it's avion, if it's flying on higher alturas, where temperature is minus, and minus, decreasing temperature, so it's going to decrease viscosidad. And decreasing viscosidad, decreasing skin friction, and it's increasing efficiency of the avion. This is one of the reasons porque avion is flying on altura about 10-11 kilometers. Porque? Porque this optimum altura where is minimum viscosidad, so minimum skin friction. Questions so far?
Not sure.
Mm-hmm. This is cinematic viscosity. Fluid viscosity, uno mass time. Like fluidos, it's gases, and liquidos, gases. What happened with viscosidad? viscosity that increases as we increase in temperature in gases. And viscosity that increases as we increase in pressure. Because increasing pressure, increasing density, it's increasing viscosity. In liquids, viscosity decreasing as temperature goes up. And it doesn't relate to the pressure because liquids we consider non-compressible and it doesn't change density with increasing or decreasing of the pressure. So this one, non-slip conditions, that it comes from the viscosity. See, if we see this plate, in this plate, let's imagine like moving some liquids like air or liquids, doesn't matter, any fluids on the top of this plate. Somewhere before this plate, we can see velocity vector of this fluid everywhere equal, the same. But as soon as it comes on the top of this plate, what happened here, it's now starts to add non-slip condition. Some of this fluid is just sticks on the surface of the solid. Sticks on the surface and it's maximum resistance, minimum velocity. Velocity equals zero. It's zero velocity at surface. This velocity vector is from the zero, it's increasing to some normal punto, like here. And this distance from the way is like zero velocity to normal velocity, we call it boundary layer. In boundary layer happened non-slip condition effect. And this is how thick, how large is this boundary layer. It gives us an idea how strong is friction, resistance, skin friction. Skin because of this surface. And skin friction because of this non-slip condition, zero velocity effect on the surface. And this is thickness in a real avion, this thickness. From those millimeters to 30 millimeters. So more than 10 times difference of this thickness around avion. Why so much difference? Because of it depends in which part of the avion, because avion like as a solid, it has like wings, it has tail part, it has fuselage, it has landing gear. And all this part of the avion creating like no exception. Everywhere happened zero velocity effect, non-slip condition. And this is boundary layer. It depends on the part of the avion. And once again, this surface, on the whole surface of the avion, thickness of this non-slip condition, it varies from the those millimeters to about like 3 centimeters. Non-slip condition. And this is important to remember when we speak about types of the arrastre. Remember, like skin friction, like or parasite drag, it's also we call it parasite drag. Skin friction and boundary layer, parasite drag, it's all the same. Another type of the free arrastre, it's forma drag, it depends on the aerodynamic forma, shape of the avion, forma drag. And another type, it's interference drag, remember? But I'm going to repeat in next class all this like different type of the arrastre for the avion. But remember this one, it's because of viscosity and non-slip condition. Classification of the fluid flow, like viscose flow against inviscid, non-viscose regions of the flow. Flow is the same, but in the same this flow, we have like highlight two parts of the flow. First, which comes close to the surface, with remember thickness from those millimeters to 3 centimeters, and this one part of this all floor, and this part, because where is happened non-slip condition, we call it viscose floor. And on the top of this one, where is velocity vector everywhere is equal, the same, it's non-viscose floor. And on the bottom of this plate, absolutely the same, viscose floor, non-viscose floor. Or in other words, area of the fluid flux on the top of the avion where has effect of the non-slip condition, zero velocity condition. This zone we call it viscose zone. Anything on the top of the zone we call it inviscid flow zone. Internal flow versus external flow. External flow of the, like if you speak about avion, it's everything, any movement of the atmosphere, air around avion, and it's outside of the avion. This is external flow. Internal flow, it's any movement of the air that goes inside of jet engine, for example. Inside of the jet engine, inside of the cooling system, it's all internal flow. So external and internal. Compressible versus incompressible flow. This is interesting things because in general, we consider like gases and liquidos, main difference between them that it's gases compressible, liquidos non-compressible. And it's absolutely right, it's absolutely correct. But when we speak about aerodynamica, we also have to remember that it's compressible, incompressible. It's also about velocidad of the moving object. For example, avion, when it flies with subsonic flow, subsonic speed, air goes around avion as a subsonic flow. And in this condition, air, gas, acts as a non-compressible, incompressible flow. If avion moves faster with sonic velocity and supersonic velocity, now air flows around avion, it's a compressible flow. So here, when we're speaking in aerodynamica, about compressible, non-compressible, it's not about liquids or gases. It's about velocidad. And velocidad of this avion, to represent velocidad, we are using category as a Mach number. Mach number, it's Mach, it's the last name of the physician. And Mach number, it's a relation of the speed of the airflow or the speed of the subject or transport related to the speed of the sound. And here, if we on the top put like speed of the sound and on the bottom speed of the sound, here we are going to have, for example, here, speed of the sound also. Speed of the sound, so we are going to have equal uno. So this is Mach number equal uno, it's sonic flow, sonic velocidad. And related to this punto, reference punto, anything below sonic or anything that its velocidad has less than sonic velocity, we call it subsonic. Mach number less than uno, it's subsonic flow. Mach number more than uno, supersonic flow. Mach number more than 5, hypersonic flow. See? Say yes.
Yes, teacher.
Good.
Uh-huh. Yes, teacher.
So this is compressible versus incompressible flow. Laminar versus turbulent flow. Here, very simple. I don't remember if we have question about laminar or turbulent flow, but still, you must know this like difference between laminar and turbulent flow and transitional flow, like between laminar and turbulent. Porque in aerodynamics, any laminar flow, it's much more better than any turbulent flow. In aerodynamic laminar flow, it means that it's less arrastre. Any turbulent flow, it mass arrastre. We have to remember. But how to change laminar to turbulent flow? It depends on few factors. And then to consider if it's flow laminar or turbulent, we are using like Reynolds number. Reynolds number, it's using widely in physics, in engineering application. It shows, like, it gives us an idea if this fluid tends to move with laminar flow or turbulent flow. And Reynolds number is an idea is, for example, if we have some tank, and as this tank azul is, for example, agua, and rojo, it's just like color to make it visible to type of the flow. And Reynolds, he notices that it's like, if like increase or decrease diameter, it's changing velocity of the moving out of amount of the fluid, and also like type of the movement, it's also changes, is varied. And what he notices that it's like if we have low discharge, it means that it's low velocity at constant diameter. It has like laminar flow. If increasing velocity, medium discharge, increasing rate of discharge, it's now not laminar, but not yet turbulent, it's transitional flow. And if we increasing, like making as high as possible discharge of this liquidus here through this diameter, flow turns to the turbulent. And he figure out that it's like, first one is laminar, transitional and turbulent flow. And this type of flow depends on the few factors. And these factors, they are velocity of fluid flow. So what does it mean? Most of the time, less velocity, most likely it's laminar flow. Mass velocity, most likely it's turbulent flow. Second one, diameter of the tube, but it's not exactly diameter. It's not here, this part, it just for this case, but it's not just diameter. It's just about this D, it stands for geometry. For example, for aerodynamic forma. Better aerodynamic forma, less this number. Worse aerodynamic forma, it changes this number. It's just mostly about aerodynamic forma, but related to our case, to our example, it's of course its diameter. Density of the fluid, it also makes difference in Reynolds number. And dynamic viscosity of the fluid, it makes difference in Reynolds number. And the Reynolds number formula is density times velocity times diameter divided by absolute viscosity, absolute or dynamic viscosity. And here, as we remember, like cinematic viscosity, it's absolute viscosity divided by density. And if here, viscosity that from here we can have like absolute viscosity to put right here. It's going to be like this forma. And finally, we are going to have both of them is right. This formula is right, and also this formula is right. This formula is considering absolute viscosity or dynamic viscosity, and this formula considering cinematic viscosity for the Reynolds number. And if it's going to be questions, like Reynolds number equal for the laminar, transitional, and turbulent flow, it's just like example for our quiz, for our class, because in real life, laminar flow, we cannot say that it's Reynolds number less than 1,000. It's always laminar flow. No, no, no. It depends on the what type of the liquidus or gases. But for our class, if I ask you laminar Reynolds number for laminar flow, it's anything less than 1,000. Transitional flow between 1,000 2,000. Turbulent flow more than 2,000. Next, natural versus like forced flow. Natural flow is just like flow in atmosphere, for example, under like this flow induced by like difference in temperature, difference in density. It's creating movement of the gas, and this movement is natural flow. Any forced flow, like we are using Avanika to create some movement, this is forced flow. Steady, unsteady, or uniform flow. And this is considered with some point of the fluid flucha, some part of the fluid flucha, where we're making analysis. Like at this point, with the time, if all parameters of the fluid flucha remains constant, we call it steady. All parameters or one parameter or those parameters that we are making analysis. Parameters that we consider if at point of at this certain point of fluid flucha, if it remains constant, we can call it steady. If it's not remains constant, it's unsteady. But if these parameters everywhere in fluid flucha is equal, we call it uniform. Because steady, unsteady, uniform, uniform, it's very important. For example, in aerodynamics, in aeroreactors, when it's like flamma going from nozzle of the jet engine, if temperature all around perimeter of the flamma it's equal or uniform, this is jet engine doing perfect job. It's not any unsteady distribution of the temperature and pressure, and it's creating equal velocity vector in any point of the like exhaust. This because of uniform flow. So just remember steady, unsteady, and uniform. One, two, or three dimensional flows. If like one, two, or three, one dimensional, it just we consider just distance. When we have very long some distance, for example, we are transporting like cerveza from Juarez to Chihuahua, and diameter of the our pipe like 10 millimeters. So compared to this distance of 400 kilometers long, to this diameter just 10 millimeters, we cannot even compare. It's not comparable, right? So this fluid flucha we can consider as a one-dimensional flow. Two-dimensional flow, mostly time, it's just to make analysis, for example, aerodynamics of the car, air moving, and we consider like vertical scale and horizontal scale, what happened with car. But when this is two-dimensional flow. three-dimensional flow, it's when we're speaking about, I'm going to make just right here. Three-dimensional flow, three-dimensional flow, just imagine. If you select here. Ugly. But it's still this avion, okay? This wing. So here we have pressure. We have mass pressure. So mass pressure, less pressure, and on the punto here, air moves like that. And on this punto, air moves like that. From the side and down wash. And to consider this type of the movement of the air, we have to consider 2D around all these avions, similar like Caro, and mass this movement of the air. So that's why to make analysis of the aerodynamics of the movement of the air around avion, we must to consider like a three-dimensional flow. So this is idea why we need uno, dos, and tres-dimensional flow in aerodynamica. Like fluid fluha now, fluid elements. Any fluid fluha we can consider as a small element, and it's this small element moving, it's creating some trajectory and flow line, and this trajectory flow line we can consider as a streamlines, path line, and streak lines. This is in general. You just have to know streamlines, path lines, streak lines. But in our practicum, mostly like engineers using just streamlines, porque for the path line and streak lines, you need a special technique and special equipment. In wind tunnel, we don't have it. So path lines, streak lines, don't pay attention. We are speaking just about streamlines. Streamlines, it's something we can see here. Azul linear, it's streamlines. Rojo linear, it's velocity vector. Vector of the velocidad. And we can see azul linear almost repeats this velocity vector. It's almost parallel, same thing. And just trajectory of this velocity vectors, it shows our streamlines. Streamlines using to show flow of the air on the top of the solids. If the solids, for example, airfoil, caro, avion, or any other subject or object. And here we can see distance between the streamlines different. Mass distance. It means that it's less velocidad between this air, less velocidad of the streamlines. Less distance, mass velocidad is here. Just remember this one. And also remember that it's streamlines, they can come very close to each other, but they never cross each other, streamlines. And once again, here we can see mass distance, between streamlines. Here, less distance, less distance. It shows that it's more velocidad. More distance, less velocidad. And here, when you see this kind of streamlines, you can say right away, that it's on the top of this ball, on the top of this ball, air moves with higher velocidad than on the bottom. Streamlines, straight lines, and pass lines no necesita, straight lines no necesita. Okay, vapor pressure. No, vapor pressure we no necesita because of vapor pressure and cavitation. It's applicable only in only in liquidos, in hydrodynamica, not in aerodynamica. Just wait, people, just a second. Questions so far?
No, teacher.
Sheila, are you sleeping?
No, teacher.
Oh, good. Okay. No, it's okay. We have to stop here because this is all mostly like basic fluid mechanics that we necessita to use in aerodynamica. So next review class, Friday. Friday, I'm going to tell you everything like related to aerodynamica and to review the most important part from aerodynamica. It's in Friday. But Mercury's class, 1 hour class, I'm going to, once again, I'm going to give you data from the wind tunnel activities. And I'm going to explain what you have to do with this data. It's kind of laboratory. Unfortunately, we couldn't make any like normal laboratory class because of all these restrictions. And here we have to stop. Just people, please remember about this coronavirus. I hate the situation. I know everyone is just fed up with this like restrictions, but we don't have any other choice. We have to follow these restrictions. We have to use mask. If necessary, keep your gloves on. If it possible, don't go outside. This disease, it's very dangerous. It's you don't even know when you can get this disease, and even if you keep all this distance, all the things. So better to stay at home, just stay at home if it's possible. But anyway, enjoy your life. Enjoy your life, and thank you for attending my class. And Unamas, I forgot, because I got mail today that it's, please, studentes, in aeronautica, please make evaluation of the teachers, like professors. Do you understand what I mean?
Yes, teacher.
Yeah, it's still.
You have a teacher.
Yeah, it's still open until November 8, but do it as soon as possible. Just try to make it as much as possible, because it's it considers like that we are working, we are meeting like online, we're still doing, trying to fight against the situation. So please make your evaluation. It's not just about Eli Russo, for other professors also, please do it online, okay?
you,
teacher.
Yes, yes, and it's going to give some benefits for us, and it's also going to give some benefits for you. So please do evaluation and see you Mercules at laboratory class. So take care of yourself, people. Bye.
See you, teacher. Thank you.
See you. Thank you.
Teacher, I have a question. Do you took attendance?
Yes, just wait. I'm going to check. Luis, right? Luis Roberto?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, okay. I'm going to check you in.
Okay. Thank you very much, teacher.
Yes, I did. I checked you in. Mm-hmm.
See you, teacher.
See you.
Teacher, me too. I'm late.
yes, yes, just wait. David. Yeah, you're right. You're here. I fix it.
Okay, teacher, thank you. See you.
See you.
Okay, bye, teacher. See you, Miércoles.
Bye, Israel. Take care of yourself.
Thank you,
Mr.
Thank you. Thank you, Roberto.